Am I Taylor Swift or am I Miranda Kennedy? So my name is Miranda Kennedy and I'm here to talk to you about identity theft. So identity theft is a big problem that happens all over the world and nobody really knows about it or they don't take the time to learn about it. It happens a lot more than people realize, and so how much do you actually really know about identity theft or what the steps people go through to learn about it or the steps that people take to take your identity? Theft is a crime and it could ruin your life. So the three points I'm going to bring to your attention today is: what is identity theft, who is affected by identity theft, and what can prevent it. So according to the article, How to Protect and Minimize Consumer Risk to Identity Theft, the United States Federal Trade Commission labeled identity theft as the most common type of consumer fraud, affecting thousands of people every day. In fact, approximately 40% of the frauds reported to the United States Federal Trade Commission in 2007 over the last few years has involved some type of identity theft. So what is it? It's a major crime that happens all over the world again. It normally happens when someone steals your information, your personal sensitive information like your name, your address, your bank information, or your social security number. People are more worried about losing their money, but in reality it's more about losing your reputation because it's a lot harder to get back. It's not difficult for anyone to take your identity. They could go to your past or your current employers and go, they can hack their database. They can steal your mail. They can overhear you talking on the phone to somebody, giving your information out. They can send you pop-ups or scams over the internet, and not many people realize what it is until they click it. And then the most common is when they hack the ATMs and the gas stations. There's three steps that they normally go through. The first step is discovery, which that's when they gain and they verify your information. The second one is the action, which they gather it up and they go through the cover-up process. And then the third is the trial to see if they actually get away with using your information. They normally start small and then they increase with the amount that they go after you for. So they'll start with just using your name and buying little purchases and selling it on the black market. Then they'll go up to taking loans out for automobiles, and then they go up to opening bank accounts and writing fraudulent checks. So according to the article, who are victims of identity theft? The effect of demographic states, older consumers have less credit cards and make fewer purchases. The risk declines with age, particularly for those of 75 years and older. So who's affected? They normally look for younger people because they aren't aware as giving out their information of what it could take. They look for females, especially with kids, because again, when they give their card to their kid to go make a purchase, again, they're still not aware of what the information they're actually giving out. They take advantage of people who aren't very educated in identity theft. And a lot goes into the process of actually taking your identity. So they look for your name, they see what race you are, they see what gender you are, and see how easy it is, because the easier it is, the easier they can get away with it. So identity theft can turn your life upside down and it can ruin your life at some point. There are many more helpful links that you can do more research on if that's something you would like to do. And now with me talking to you about this, I hope you're able to stop it before it happens to you. Thank you.